Hi friends, today and we are going to discuss the practical question number 2 from ICAI study material, retirement of a partner, practical question number 2. And of course it is and quite similar some this kind of some already we have done the illustrations, but of course there is a slight difference in this problem, and let us check it and what is the difference. Okay. ABC are partners sharing profits losses in 3:2:1. The balance sheet of the firm given on 31st March 2016 like this. On the date of retirement of A, of course out of ABC, A is retiring, B and C will continue. The balance sheet given like this: goodwill, fixtures, stock, debtors, cash. And the when you come to the liability side, capitals of A, B and C, sundry creditors. This is the balance sheet given you. Let us check it. A on account of ill health and gave a notice, and he decided to retire from the firm. Out of ABC, due to ill health, A wanted to retire from business. A retirement agreement was therefore entered on 31st March 2016, and the following, based on the following terms. First point given: the profit and loss account for the year ended 31st March 2016, which showed a net profit of 42,000, was to be reopened, which means 42,000 already distributed to all of them in 3:2:1, and that profit is the part and parcel of their capitals right now. But here, and you have to reverse that profit. When you share the profit P&L to partner's capital, right now you may write partner's capitals to P&L or P&L adjustment account. Let us reopen the profit. And why? Because B was to be credited as a 6,000 bonus. So 6,000 bonus to be given, extra work done by the B. And thereby you can write, once the profit is being reversed and P&L, out of P&L adjustment, through P&L adjustment you can give the bonus to B, for which entry P&L adjustment account data to B's capital account. Obviously 42 minus 6,000, remaining amount can be distributed. It is given like this. And the profit sharing basis was revised, and the revised ratio to is 2:3:1, and it is to be implemented from 1st April 2015. Means that changed ratio should be implemented since beginning of the year, and this ratio to be applied. Means the revised profit should be shared in this ratio, new ratio, and moreover this ratio is applicable for the entire year for ABC, 2:3:1. Goodwill to be valued 2 years average profits of the past 5 years given. Profits for these years given like this: 31st March 2012, 15,000, 13, 23,000, 14, 25,000, 15, 35,000, 16, 42,000. You can see here calculation of the firm goodwill. And I have taken 5 years profits in the numerator. You can add all of them. So divided by 5, and you can get the average. It is given 2 years profit is the firm goodwill. So you can multiply with 2. So therefore firm goodwill here is 56,000. 5 years profits are given. You can add all of them, divided by 5 into 2. 2 years average is the firm goodwill. That is the firm goodwill right now. So on the date of retirement, 56,000. Okay. Fixtures to be valued at 39,800. Earlier fixtures 30,000. There is increase 9,500, which is a gain. Okay. So you can credit to revaluation or P&L adjustment account, or you can directly credit that gain to partner's capital accounts also. Provision 2% to be made on the debtors. 90,000 debtors is there, 2% provision, anticipated loss 2%, which is 1,800. That is to be considered at the time of retirement. Two assets are revalued. One, increase upward evaluation, fixtures by 9,800. Provision for bad debt is an anticipated loss. Remaining assets to be considered at their book value only. Okay. That the amount payable to A shall be paid by B. The person who is retiring, let us ascertain the amount to be given to A. If you are able to give, firm is going to give that money, A's capital account data to cash. But here that amount is given by the B. Therefore, you can make the B as a creditor to that amount. Therefore, entry A's capital account debtor to B's capital account. B settle the debt of A, amount payable to A. B and C agreed as between themselves to continue the business after the retirement of A, sharing profits losses in the ratio of 3:1. B and C, they decided to share future profits in 3:1. That will be the new ratio after the retirement of A, 3:1. Firm goodwill should be eliminated. To retain the fixtures at the revised value, they decided to continue fixtures at the same value, but they want to remove the goodwill, and provision for bad debts increased it to 6%. Earlier it was given 2%, but it is increased to 6%, means they want to create 4% more provision for bad debts by the B and C. Total capital of the firm will be 3 lakhs as before, to be maintained in the new ratio. So earlier 3 lakhs capital was there before retirement of A, 1 lakh 50, 1 lakh and 50 thousand. Even after retirement of A, B and C, they decided to maintain the same firm capital 3 lakhs, but they want to maintain in the new ratio. New ratio in the sense 3:1. 3 lakhs into 3:1 means 2 lakh 25 thousand and 75 thousand. 3 lakhs into 3:1, 3 by 4, 1 by 4, 2 lakh 25 and 75 thousand. They want to maintain the capitals. To maintain the capitals like that, and whatever the amount they are supposed to bring, and they can bring. Otherwise, if there is any excess capital, of course it can be withdrawn. Okay, you are required to give the necessary entries and prepare partners capital accounts, cash account and balance sheet of B and C. So let us write the journal entries and partners capital accounts, and of course cash account also, and we need to prepare a revised balance sheet, and we have to work out. Let us work out one by one. First come to the entries. P&L, whatever the profit already shared, that should be reversed. Then you share the profit P&L to partners capital. When you would like to reverse partners capital to P&L or P&L adjustment account, and you check it if there is a profit already shared 42, that is to be reversed. And therefore you may write the entry like this. First entry, A's capital account debtor, B's capital account debtor, C's capital account debtor to P&L adjustment account. So this is 42,000 you would like to reverse right now, and their ratio, and they were shared in 3:2:1. In that ratio you have to reverse. If you reverse in that ratio, the amount will be like this: 21,000, 14,000, 7,000. Okay, so being profit written back by partners, okay, after that they decided to give the and they decided to give a bonus of 6,000 rupees, for which P&L adjustment account debtor to B's capital account 6,000, being bonus payable to B. Okay, now their revised profit 42 minus 6 and it will be 36. That profit should be distributed to the partners, not in this ratio. They decided to change the ratio since beginning of this year, so you need to share in the new ratio. Moreover, we should say that is not the new ratio, that will be old ratio, because that is what we are implementing that since beginning of the year. Now you may call new ratio, but practically it is a old, it will become old ratio, because the entire profits are distributed in that ratio, that is a 2:3:1. Therefore entry will be like this: P&L adjustment account debtor to A's capital to B's capital to C's capital. The revised profit is 36,000 and that is to be distributed in the new ratio, what they decided, 2:3:1. and if you share in that ratio, and it will be credited like this: 12,000, 18,000, and 6,000. Okay, so being profit distributed in new ratio, being profit distributed in new ratio. Okay, and next one. So in fact, profit being reversed, bonus given to B, and revised profit shared to all of them in the agreed new ratio. And at the time of retirement, and they decided to fourth entry. At the time of retirement, they decided to revalue two assets, particularly one fixtures. Earlier it was 30,000, but they decided right now 39,800. Increase in fixed assets 9,800. So you may asset account data to revaluation. Provision for bad debts to be created 2% on debtors. 90,000 debtors, 2% means 1,800 provision for bad debt anticipated loss. Revaluation or P&L adjustment account data to provision for bad debts. Instead of crediting and debiting to revaluation account and sharing that, let us do directly one thing. Fixtures account data, which is increase in asset, to provision for bad debt anticipated loss, instead of debiting to revaluation, and directly you can credit by the provision for bad debts. Moreover, goodwill earlier balance sheet item 40,000, but right now it is 56,000. In the balance sheet, goodwill 40,000 there means it is already distributed to them. Now 16,000 you can distribute, 40,000 already distributed to them. Remaining 16,000 if you distribute, that is sufficient. So let us do one thing. 16,000 goodwill let us bring to the books, goodwill account data. Increase in fixed assets fixtures by 9,800, fixtures account data. Anticipated loss, provision for bad debts, to provision for bad debts account. Decrease in asset, therefore I am crediting that. Directly the result you can share to all partners in the given ratio, which is 2:3:1, because it is implemented since beginning. Therefore you may write the entry like this: goodwill account data, write in brackets, right now 56,000, earlier 40,000, increase by 16,000, because 40,000 already in their capitals, but right now I want to share the remaining 16,000 only. Okay, increase in fixtures, fixtures account to debtor 9,800, provision for bad debt, decrease in asset, so you have to credit to provision for bad debts anticipated loss 90,000 into 2%, that is 1,800. Okay, so therefore 25,800, 1,800 minus 24,000, that is to be distributed to all of them ABC in the this ratio 2:3:1. So you may say that to A's capital account, to B's capital account, to C's capital account in the ratio of 2:3:1. Okay, and if you share, and you may credit like this: 8,000, 12,000, and 4,000. Okay, so being revaluation of assets on A's retirement. On the A's retirement, the assets revalued like this: increase in fixed assets, increase in goodwill, and anticipated loss, provision for bad debts, decrease in asset. The net as a result is shared to all of them in the 2:3:1, and because that ratio is implemented since beginning of the year. Okay, and after that, and they decided two important points here, and whatever the amount to be given to A, that amount is given by the B, for which I said that A's capital account data to B's capital account, and that entry we need to write. And one more thing they decided after settlement to A, and they want to write off the goodwill completely once we send him out, where you write A's capital to B's capital, and goodwill to be written off, and they decided to increase provision for bad debt to 6%. So two more entries and we have to write. While writing two more entries, let us complete the partner's capital accounts first. First, let us take the partner's capital as by balance brought down 1,50,000 1,50,000. Okay, so now let us record these items. ABC to P&L adjustment. In the ABC to P&L adjustment, 21,000, 14,000, 7,000. And P&L adjustment to B's capital. In the B's capital by P&L adjustment, bonus 6,000. Revised profit shared by P&L adjustment, 12,86. Revised profit shared, and so goodwill, fixed assets and provision for bad debt put together is adjusted to partner's capital accounts. So credit side by goodwill, fixed assets, or fixtures, and reduced by PBD. Goodwill by goodwill as well as fixed assets, and also reduced by provision for bad debts. Net amount is credited to all of them, 8,000, 12,000, 4,000. That's all. These are the items, and particularly let us check the person who is retiring. Let us check the amount to be given to him. So if you check A's credit total, it looks 1,70,000. 1,70,000. 21,000 minus 1,41,000. That should be given by B. A's capital account data to B's capital. So 1,49,000. In the A's capital to B's capital, in the B's capital by A's capital. Okay, so 1,49,000. In the A's capital to B, in the B's capital by A's capital, 1,49,000. Over. And next, of course, you may write the entry for this. And one more entry, the last entry is left. Let us work out the last two entries. And fifth entry, that is A's capital account data, B's capital account, 1,49,000. 1,49,000 being amount payable to A, being amount payable to A by B, 1,49,000. And one more last entry is required, that already once the retirement partner's account is being settled like this, and here onwards they decided to share future profits in 3:1, and obviously here onwards and whatever they do, and that should be done only in the new ratio, which is 3:1. And what they decided, they want to write off the goodwill, remove the goodwill from your books, and you have to create 4% provision for bad debt additionally. Reduce the goodwill should be removed, means you have to credit anticipated loss. Provision for bad debts also reduce your asset, means credit by both these, and definitely it will be like a loss and debited to continuing partners in the new ratio, because they decided to remove the goodwill and they want to create a provision for bad debt. Simply you may write the entry like this: B's capital account to debt R, C's capital account to debt R. So the book value of goodwill is 56,000. They decided to remove 56,000 and they want to create two provision for bad debts additionally. The debt R is 90,000
they decided to 6%, which is 5400. 5400 minus already we created provision earlier 1800, and therefore 3600 you have to create right now additionally. This is what required. This is already created, so difference you can create right now, and this should be debited to them in 3:1 ratio. If you debit like that, it will be 44,700, 14,900. If you share like this, 44,700 and 14,900. Okay, so being goodwill written off and provision for bad debt created. Provision for bad debts created. Of course, this entry already recorded, but we need to write this entry. In the B and C, you have to debit to goodwill and PBD, provision for bad debts. So it should be debited to the B and C, 44,700 as well as 14,900. That's all. So of course, AS capital account is settled. Remaining two partners, they need to maintain the capital balance like this. 3 lakhs newly reconstituted firm capital. So between B and C, the new ratio is 3:1. Okay, 3:1. 3:1 in the sense 3/4, 1/4, 75,000 and 2,25,000. So here 2,25,000, here it is 75,000. So to maintain the capitals like this, and you can cross check the A, B and C, debit as well as credit. If credit side is more like a creditor, you have to pay. If debit side is more debtor, and you have to collect, firm has to collect. So B is looking like a credit side is more it is looking like a, so the therefore credit total is 2,85,000. 2,85,000, and you have to pay 1300 rupees to B to maintain the capital like that, to cash 1,300. But if you check the C, the debit side is looking more 96,900, which means he should bring the money into business. There you can write buy cash, and of course he can bring the amount 36,900 to maintain the capitals. So in this manner, so one is supposed to bring, another one is supposed to pay. So we paid to B and C brought into the business. Let us see how cash is changed because of these entries. Already in your old balance sheet, you are having a cash balance given at 10,000 rupees. And of course, C brought in cash to C's capital, 36,900. And moreover, so to B we paid, B to cash in the cash account by B's capital. By B's capital, of course, 1300 rupees. That's all. No more. You can balance it. 46,900. Balance 45,600. Two balance brought down. 45,600. This is the balance which I have to take into the newly reconstituted balance sheet. Yeah, by the support of your old balance sheet, and we can prepare a new balance sheet at the end. And say so simple to prepare a new balance sheet. So by the support of your old balance sheet, let us see how to prepare the newly reconstituted balance sheet of B as well as C, because A is retired. So balance sheet of B and C as at 31st March 2016. Okay. So this is the way to work out liabilities. Amount rupees, assets,
amount rupees. Let us check the assets one by one and whatever we have to take. Goodwill need not to take because it is remote. Fixtures, stock, debtors, cash. We can take all of them. Fixtures given at 30,000
plus 9,800, 39,800. Stock, there is no increase, no decrease, 1,70,000. Sundry debtors, right in inner column, 90,000. Minus PBD, earlier 2%, later 4%, total 6%, 5,400. 84,600. And take the cash or bank balance, revised balance 45,600. Come to the liability side, take the capital accounts. You can take the capitals of B as well as C, 2,25,000, 75,000. There is only one liability, that is sundry creditors, no increase, no decrease, take as it is 40,000. And therefore total 3,40,000. 3,40,000. The total of the balance sheet 3,40,000. That's all. This is the simple way to solve this problem, and by this we completed the entire partnership. We discussed the partnership basics, fundamentals, valuation of goodwill, and admission, retirement, death, and everything we discuss related to partnership. And definitely I believe that all these videos can be definitely useful to you, and definitely we can go to the another new topic in the next class. Okay, bye.